What I'm about to say is gonna cover the best way for using Vray Proxy feature in 3dsmax and also solving issues that may face you, like Vray mesh support missing or the proxy itself is out of scale. So let's jump right in. Welcome guys again to a new tutorial. We usually use Vray Proxy feature for big projects or big models or an object that we wanna use it many times to reduce the amount of polygons and vertices in order to make the project light in viewport or at the rendering. So for example, this scene, if I want to know the exact amount of polygons and vertices for this scene, I will go to this plus sign, left click on it, then scroll down to configure viewport, then this window will show up. From this window, I will click on statistics, then selectoral plus selection, and show statistics in active view. Hit apply, then hit OK. And as you can see here, is the total amount of the polygons and vertices for this project. This is the polygons, 731,000, and the vertices is 756,000. And as you can see here, if I select this car and name it from here, car, as you can see here, appeared the amount polygons and vertices for this car. So the total amount of the polygons is 731,000 and for only the car is 728,000, and the whole project except the car is just 3,000 faces and 3,000 vertices. So what if I have 4 or for example 5 cars and 10 types of trees? What am I gonna do? Here comes the benefit of the Vray Proxy feature. To reduce the amount of the polygons and vertices in the viewport, as well as not damaging and saving the high poly of the object itself. So how can I use the Vray Proxy in a proper way? Firstly, you will prepare the model or the object for the proxy. Select the model and isolate it. Then ungroup it. After that, select one of its items and convert it to edit poly. Then go to attach and click on attach list. Then the attach list will show up. Select all of them by Ctrl A, then select attach. And the attach option should be on match material IDs to material. Now the car turned into an object. And as you can see, not big deal change into its polygons and vertices. After that, I will draw the object material into a slot material, because the proxy object will come without materials. I'll open the material editor, select any slot, then pick the materials from the object. And I get to name it. I'll just write car. And I can rename the object itself. If I write down car 1, now I want to put the model exactly where I want it to be. I'll unisolate it. It looks bigger than the actual cars, so I'm going to measure it. Go to utilities and select measure. From here you can see the length and width and height is too much for the car, so I'll resize it just like this. Then I'll put it exactly where I want it to be, from the top view and from the side view. After that, right click using the mouse and select Vray mesh export. But I can't find it. It's missing, and this is one of the problems that you may face it. But it's simply to solve. There are two ways to solve this problem. First, by going to customize, custom UI and default switcher. Select maximum Vray and click on set. Close the 3dsmax and open it again. The other way to do that, by going to scripting and select max script listener and write down register Vray menus 2 brackets and hit OK. If you saw the word OK or true after you hit OK, that means it worked. or you can write it just right here and it will work again. So I'll select the model, right click Vray mesh export. From here I get to select the folder that I want to save it on, and from max preview faces I get to put the faces that is gonna be on my viewport and workflow instead of the old polygons. Here is 100 max preview faces, and here is 1000 max preview faces, and here is 50,000 max preview faces. For this model I'll choose 5000, then hit OK. After that I will go to the command panel, go to geometry, click on standard primitives, scroll down to Vray, click on Vray, then click on Vray proxy. After that click on anywhere in the viewport, then this window will pop up, then go to the place that you have saved the Vray proxy on it and select it, just like this. As you can see it worked out, its polygons is 5000, but the problem it went out of scale, and this is the second problem that you may face it. So in order to solve that, just let's delete this one, select the original one, go to utilities, reset its form, reset selected, and that is all, and repeat again the whole process. Vray mesh export, max preview faces 5000, and hit OK. Create geometry, Vray, Vray proxy, select the file, this time it is the same scale, let us put it at the same line, then give it the material that you have drawn from the original object, just like this. This one is 5000 polygons and this one is 7028 polygons, and if I delete it, the total number of the whole project will be 8500 just. So undo the delete and see the test render for it. That is all for today. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. See you next time.